What is good, guys? I'm here with a solo live this time, and I made this nice and fun team around SD the Blade, because Medichim is like a really big threat, right? And I wanted like a good way to check Medichim. So, but it's offensive the Blade, we're not the defensive, we're the SD max attack set. We got some nice Scarf and Furnape here. This is my friend's account, it's T-Bra, because I haven't let it on my two main accounts. This one should be, should have some points. Let's see. We have defensive standard Landorus, we have Electrium Z Latios, we have Choice Band Tapu Bulu, which is a really cool one, but I haven't used it in a long time. Bulu's a decent lead versus like the Coco and the Garchomp and the Landorus. Versus half his team is a decent lead, but it's not good versus Gengar. But when he leads Gengar, I can just go into my Alola here. That's a perfectly fine switch, and he could go for Trick if he's Scarf. And close on programs I have in the background. One sec, I'm gotta pause really quick. He specs Gengar for sure, did a lot. So he can go for like Spadeftra or crits here. I can fire off a knockoff here. I don't see what I lose from firing off a knockoff. I don't think he would stay in. Like, wishing was also an option, but getting rid of the Coco Zap plate is really nice. We can just go hard Bulu. Maybe I should have made this Bulu max HP to switch into Coco. Fine. It's Toxic Coco, nice set. Damn, that was really annoying. But yeah, I'm just gonna fire off a Banner Woodhammer here. Switch-ins are not really existent. But yeah, Medivis is his only switch-in. Medivis is like one of the best Bulu checks. Like, Banner Bulu doesn't have good switch-ins, but of course he has Metagross, the one like kind of switch-in. This will get blown away. He might live on 10%. Okay, 26. Wow, so he's max defense. I take 5 million recoil. If I kill this, I die. But Bulu is so slow, so I'm not outspeeding much on his team, so let's just take the kill. Like, I know I die here, but I wasn't doing much more work at that amount of health. Reaper burned rocks from that, so he's probably Zenith Garchomp then. Let's just go into Scarf and Furnape here. It seems to have the best matchup. Yeah, he could be Scarf Jump, honestly, because he's weak to Volcarona, like every team. He could have Shuriken and Greninja though, so that's something he can have to check Volcarona. Get up rocks and then Shuriken it. But that doesn't always work. So he's definitely, he has to be Scarf Jump, like maybe the Greninja then. I don't know if I've talked about everything. Yeah, I told you guys I have the move Laddie, right? I can just fire the Flare Blitz. He can go Garchomp if he wants to. I was thinking about putting Gangshot on this for Tapu Fini, but I put Stone Edge for now. He's gonna go Garchomp. Yeah, that was obvious. I should have doubled, but I should have just gone Iron Mola. Now I reveal that I'm Scarf, but I get the Grassy Terrain Recovery. And I can just throw my Landorus in here, potentially get up rocks depending on what he does. Yeah, he gets up his own rocks, so he's rocks jump even though he had a helm Landorus. This is weird. I have default on my Laddy, so I can click Earthquake because he doesn't have Earthquake Subvisions. I don't want to go Greninja on my rocks. Oh, Metagross, exactly. Yeah, that's why I wanted to Earthquake. Nice damage. And now I can basically go into my the Blade or Alamola. I want to go the Blade here. And fire off a Shadow Snake then, depending on what he does here. Goes for Mash, doesn't get the boost. And his Greninja prevents me from sweeping. I put Shadow Glove on now, maybe Secret Sword is better on this. Whatever that move is called, Sacred Sword, I think. Let me think here. If he goes Greninja on my Shadow Sneak, I still have Alamola to check that. Let's just go for Shadow Sneak, like, in case he stays in. Nice. We got rid of that. I haven't tested this team at all. I don't know if I mentioned that. This team might be complete dong. My next attack, Gengar might die to his Shadow Sneak. I don't know why he went into Gengar. He has to be back Gar from the damage he did to my Alamomola. So I'm next attack Adamant. Shadow Sneak doesn't kill. That's weird. He's just gonna go Shadow Ball. I have no switch-ins. The Blade doesn't do that much, so I don't think I want to switch. I just want to get the damage off. Yeah, it's the cursed body off, but I'm dead anyway, so that doesn't matter. And now we can just go Alamomola or Inferno. I don't know if U-turn would kill this. Let me calc. Then it's 11 to 14%, so that doesn't kill. Yeah, let's just go Alamomola then. Throw up a wish. She goes Capo Coco. It would be nice to have Mirror Code on this, but he's probably gonna U-turn out on the Laddie. The Zaplet was knocked off and I'm Spadef, so like it's not like he can kill me or anything. He just toxics me. Okay, that's really, really, really annoying. Yeah, I played this pathetic. I don't know what I'm doing. That voltage is so much. I needed this for the Gengar. What am I doing? The Gengar's out of rocks range, even if I get a rocks up. God, why did I let this get weakened? This thing was so important for Greninja. I'm gonna predict a Dark Pulse and throw my Ape in, but if he goes for a Water Move here. Okay, goes for Ice Beam. He's probably don't freeze me. That was risky as flip. I can go for Close Combat. The Close Combat invites the Gengar, so I'm gonna just U-turn out. If he Scarf Rocks, this guy's a Bluff Master. Now he could be Scarf Rocks. Let's just go into Landorus. Click Earthquake. Because he still doesn't have switch-ins for it. He decides to go for Outrage and crit me! Pokemon is a good fucking game. I could have got my Rocks up there if he didn't crit me on the following turn. So he's Protein Ninja. This isn't doing anything at this point. It's just I can't do anything. I can't switch. Why he just decided to take helmet damage for no reason, okay? Okay, so I wanna switch Scarf Greninja. Oh my god, I kinda lose to that at this point. Cause I let my Alamomola get poisoned. That was played awful by me, good god. So Coco is a problem to this team. Yeah, after Bulu dies especially. And this weird toxic set, that's not a set, dude, what the fuck? Nice C team, dude. Kind of forced into AP. I could have gone Laddie too. Yeah, let's just click Flare Birds. Like, he's probably gonna stack his Gengar. Oh, Scavenger will just revenge me then, yeah. The thing is, you have to go for a water move, right? So I can go into Latios here. I could have gone Alamomola. He goes for Gunk Shot. Yeah, I'm lucky and bad. I'm lucky and bad. Let me go for the Z move here. Giga Volt Havoc. Okay, we dodge again. The second dodge didn't matter, but oof, I feel bad. The dude just forfeited. Yeah, I didn't play that well. I didn't deserve to win that. I don't know what I'm doing. I should have tested his team. Now the way I played around the way I played around the Coco was freaking awful. Like maybe I should have gone into Larry on the Coco. I should have never let my Alamomola get toxic. Let's just say fun as we see some sticky webs. This guy has some checks for the Blade. We still don't manage him. I mean, I can just go lead with Tabu Bulu or lead with Landorus. I can leave with Tapu-Bulu, yeah. I don't know if Home Leech Trade KOs this, but I don't feel like calking. We're just gonna find out. And I'm not trying to take 5 million recoil. I should calc this, but okay, it does Trade KO. It's a roll, I guess. He doesn't have switch ins. It doesn't Trade KO because of Grassy Terrain. Yeah, fucked up. Oh, nice. We got a max roll. Whew, it's lit. So this is gonna icicle crash. He's faster if he's, the jolly version. I can go to blade here since we have the grassy terrain. Since we have the grassy terrain, earthquake doesn't do that much. So this is amazing. He's life orb, so he takes some chip. I could have even gone other mola. I don't know why I decided the blade was the play. That was a weird decision on my part. You can go Rotom here, or you can go for Earthquake and get chip damage. I feel like Tapu Bulu is a good mid ground because he either Earthquake or he goes Rotom. He stayed in. Yeah, I don't agree with that one. Should have got Alamomola though, I played that poor. But I can go Alamomola now. He misses, that doesn't matter. Terrain will end now, but that's fine. I'm gonna like knock off here. He's gonna go Rotom, I think. Oh, Superior, okay. It's life of Superior. Whoa, that's odd. Oh, dang. The webs are a huge problem. I don't think. What does run Dragon Pulse? Like, Latias is not common as meta. I hope he doesn't have Dragon Pulse. She has Drain Pools, and I just got swept. But yeah, I have to go for Draco here. Oh yeah, he has Drain Pools. That's not a set, dude. This guy's a C-team. I mean, I'm not trying to shit-talk you, like, he obviously brought this in at the right point, like, I'm just saying, like, that's not a set, dude. Who runs that? Like, this just blows my entire team away now. Huh? I remember I caught Amamala, I could have blown this guy back, but of course. Why not 6 out by Dragon Pulse Superior? God, Napier Slower. Bulu probably dies to HP fire. Like, Bulu's bulk is pretty bad. Like, I don't even have HP on my Bulu. Choice Band versus Superior. Let's say plus 2. Speed fire doesn't kill, wow. Okay, so I can go Tapu Bulu here and click Woodhammer, I guess. This is looking bleak though. Like, I just sent on Lari for nothing. Nah, it wasn't for nothing because Tapu Bulu couldn't have switched on Leaf Storm. Leaf Storm into HP fire would have killed Bulu. But I can't defog anymore. My Scarfape is gonna be handicapped. Not my Scarfape outspeeds most of his team. Unless his circuitry gets a speed boost from the Zeebnose thing. Tapu is like the only thing that would spit my nape anyway. Yeah, it doesn't kill like the cult said, and Woodhammer kills him because I'm banned. I got down. That's fine. Kind of. Like, at least I didn't get swept by that. So he's gonna go Rotom here potentially. Rotom just beats my team down. Like, I lost my two Rotomances. Yeah, I don't know if I even have a win condition now versus Rotom. Like, oh, he didn't go Rotom. He went this. So I can fire off a CC, which would give the Mimikyu setup, or I can go for Flare Blitz. But yeah, I'm just gonna CC. I don't think he will. I think he will just stay in. Oh, he will go Rotom. I don't think he will go Mimikyu. Heart Mimikyu is not an option anymore. He stays in. Monosman goes down. Amazing Scarf Nip picking up the kill. Yeah, I don't really like how I played this first battle, and I don't really like how this team turned out. Like, this team has like more weaknesses than I expected. I haven't tested it enough. Like, haven't tested it at all, like I said, I mean. But yeah, we got to Intimidate. Namimi Hiroi doubles out into Zergtree. So I got a scout for an HPI, which means I should just go hard Napier. I mean, if he's Zeognosis, I'm done anyway. Like, my only play is going hard Nape, and like, I don't have another play. Okay, goes for HPI, and I don't know if close combat kills us. I probably have to go for Flubbles here. He will probably go out into the Rotom. I don't know why I said probably so often. But yeah. So you see in Flubbles. Oh, same base power. I don't know what I'm talking about. Yeah, let's just go for CC then. Cause yeah, exactly, hits the Rotom harder than Flubbles. Oh my god, he's offensive Rotom. So he could be Scarf Rotom, which means I don't wanna stay in on a potential Scarf Rotom, so if he Volt Switches here and Circuitry comes in, that's problematic. But if I lose my Scarf Nape, I just lose to Zergtree, so let's go. Molas, he doubles Mimikyu. That doesn't do anything. I still have my Landorus intact, so I can just go for Scald, try to get a burn here. Nah, I just want to go hard Landorus. He goes Rotom. Ah, going for Knockoff, that would have been amazing. Yeah, I want to keep this, so I will just go Molas. I think the third one Scarf, the way it took so much from CC. Scarf or Specs? Oh, that's not Specs, maybe? I'm mixed with Death, so I don't know. But yeah, we can go for Knockoff here. Can also double into Nape, can also go for Scald. Knockoff seems fine here. Now we will know if it's Z-move, and it is Z-move Zergtree, so I think the T-Bolt kills my Nape. T-Bolt does 81 to 96. So that's a roll. He needs a mid roll. Yeah, this is bad. Let's go to Blade. If he Z-move Hypnosis, I'm pretty much done. Yeah, he goes for T-Bolt, and I can go for Shadow Sneak. Get the chip damage that I need off. I mean, this is guaranteed in range anyway for close combat or Flubbles. Get the spit attack boost, and we can go on Nape and click Flubbles. So we don't want him going Mimikyu on a CC as he goes Rotom. That doesn't live because he's offensive Rotom. We can still lose the circuit, we have to be really careful. Yeah, I just go Lando, I think. But if he doubles, yeah, I need this. I have to go Lando. He goes for Player Off, and I'm free to click Earthquake here. U-turn. Earthquake is free here. We sex off the Zergtree, and this game is over. Okay, good. We got one more for sure after. Like, I know this isn't the best team, but I'm. Played that okay then at the ending. Like at the beginning I was a bit sloppy, I don't know, I didn't like my plays at the beginning. I'm also still considering changes that I could make. I don't know why he SD'd again. Like, so we are in the 1571s. Shoutouts to my friend T, I guess we will hopefully appreciate that I'm learning an assault, and we get some stall. So he doesn't have if I play my type of bully well, I can win this. He doesn't have a Skarmory on his team. So he's gonna leave with Sableye. We can leave with Tapu Bulu or with Infernape. Thing is, if he stays regular with the Sableye, he can whisk my Bulu. So let's just leave with Nape or Lando. I feel like Lando, I'm going for U-turn. Because there will even Mega Evolve, because he doesn't want rocks. Nah, he made the. Okay, that was. I guess that was smart. If I went for rocks, I don't agree with that play, but it worked out, so whatever. Yeah, this is bad, like really, really bad. I can go nape and U-turn out because he has a Pex and... he has a Pex and a Tren and a Clef and a Scepter. This is just awful. I guess I shouldn't have let Lando. I just don't agree with not Mega Evolving there, because if I get Rocks up and I play it the way that I pressure your Zapdos... like, I can pressure your Zapdos from, so you don't get a defog off, so I don't agree with not Megaing there, but whatever. Now he probably could have gotten a defog off, but I still didn't like his play there. Yeah, that's just... nah, he's probably going for knockoff here. Yeah, this is awful. I can just click X. Yes, I didn't play that well. Okay, went for recover. Getting the bullet in there would have been amazing. Like, what do I even U-turn out into nape? Because I don't need my scarf, yeah. I guess I can click Flabless once, even though it's a bad play. Like, he shouldn't stay in, but this guy's just staying in. He doesn't care. What's his rank? I don't get what this guy's, like, how this guy's playing. He just stays in with his Sable and everything. Okay, it's pretty bad. It's 80 GXC, but the one loss is not good. I mean, why this GXC on the soul is complete trash on most of my alls. Because I'm just playing around with the fun teams, but there's no point in making excuses. I know I'm not the greatest in Sun and Moon OU. That's also the reason why the Roto Top 10 is paused at the moment, because I struggle with the meta, because there's always changes, like... now for almost like a ban, Medicham came out. Pretty soon there might be another suspect test, either Greninja or Metagross, that I'm hopeful we'll see another suspect, because we have some broken ones in this tier. And then like, new Megas come out every now and then, so the tier is just not settled down, if that's the way I should say it. I don't know if that's the right term. That's probably what Amos doing, he's probably just waiting for... oh, he's Fist of Sabler. That's not a set, my man. Fist of Sabler is not a set, what do you... I know you have a doggy, but you lose to Magma Tren besides that. So I'm just going for the Burny, I guess. Just spamming Recover. It's U-turn out. I don't think he will go for Will-O-Wisp the specific turn, because I'm pretty much showing that I'm... spamming Flabbers here, so he might switch, or he might go for Recover or Knockoff again. Could see him going to Toxapex. Like, if I'm him, I would have gone Toxapex. Last turn already, I don't know why he's clicked Recover again, risking a burn. Or whatever, like... I mean, his plays work, but I just would play it a bit different if I was him. This is some super weird stall, this looks like some... it's like X and Y stall, and he took the chancy away, and he... not the X, Y, or stall, he took the chancy away, put a Duggy. I mean, Duggy's pretty much nice to have on stall, pretty much important. Yeah, we U-turn out here on the Toxapex, and I can click Banned Woodhammer with my Bulu, or he's a Jack Bun into Duggy. Okay, this is gay. Oh no, he can just trap me because I'm not Scarf anymore, amazing. I can try to switch, but yeah. I mean, that's a common strategy, I've seen that multiple times, not much I can do. So I go Lando now, I U-turn out on a Sableye. I guess I like have to search my mistakes, the mistakes at my side. Like, this team is not really good versus style, probably. Banner Blue is my only breaker, like, and that doesn't even beat Stall. When it has Skarmory. He doesn't have Skarm, so... since he has a Heat Train, so I have to predict perfectly. I have to go Super Power on the right turn. He will probably go Pex the first time I'm in. He will probably go Pex slash Zapdos, but I will just click Boot Hammer, like... since he's Fizz Death, I don't know if he will live. Like, if my Bullet dies, I'm just clicking X. I don't think I can win this game, but I can attempt. But yeah, so... as soon as my blue gets burned or dies, I can just click that X button ASAP, and there's no point in trying. Like, I built this team like kind of fast, as I built most of my teams, and then I just make changes afterwards most of the time. And he stays on Sexus Sableye, so yeah, I figured he might do that, because like, I didn't really know. I agree with the way he was playing. He gets a new teacher now. Wanna bring in Malari, even though maybe I should have gone Alamomola. He doesn't get a burn there, which is nice to see. I can pretty much click Thunder here. You should scout for Surf/ Earthquake, so I expect him to go Toxapex or Clefable, so maybe you should make a double if I'm expecting. A double into Tapu Bulu would be nice, but Tapu Bulu is my win condition, so I'm not doing that. The next time I have my Bulu in, I'm either going for Superpower or for Woodhammer again. Probably Superpower predicting to go Heatran. Toxapex is also the play, like always a play you can make though. Yeah, he stays in. This guy's really bad. I'm not scouting for Earthquake or Surf, there's an awful play. Yeah, this guy's bad. Just get some damage on this as he goes for protect. Yeah, this guy's awful. Like, why would you protect there? Like, I had no reason to stay in there, right? How did you, like, it worked out, but this play was just awful. Like, nah, like 90% of the time I switched there. Like, I just wanted to get some damage on this. Whatever, man, this guy's bad. Okay, I've said that too much. I'm repeating myself. This is there's no point in saying it more. Let's just knock this off. Yeah, that does a lot, dude. I'm super deaf. Why is it doing so much? I can go for protect here. Next turn I can go Landorus. Like, if he goes for HBIs, I don't really care. My Landorus is not doing much. Like, this is defog anyway. It's not like I'm getting rocks. Yeah, he predicts that, but that doesn't do anything, like I said. What do I even do afterwards? Like, I lose my Landorus, what do I do after? Like, Stonehenge doesn't kill this, right? Tapu Bulu versus Zapdos. Yeah, this team has, like, oof, some flaws. I'm not Sword Stance, I'm Bandit. Stonehenge does 75 to 89, so I need to roll my face. Like, I need to roll to kill him. He might also be fast if he's running more speed. But yeah, it's not like I have another play. He shouldn't stay in, he should go PAX. He should really go PAX, but do I go off him being bad? Like, yeah, like I should have gone for Woodhammer, but okay, never mind. I don't know why he went Trent over PAX. Yeah, this guy's awful. Like, I can just repeat myself. I don't agree with how the guy's playing. So yeah, it works, but that was not the play when you have a pack, so whatever. To each their own. Good players. Let's just go Luddy. I mean, I can't break his team, there's no point in like crying here, like there's no point in calling him bad. Like, Gratitude just gets him healthy. My only play that was going for crit, I guess. We disconnected. Oof, I hope he doesn't come back. Let's just go for recover here. I guess that's my win con, that he doesn't come back, but yeah, let's just get some chip damage, not much I can do, like. Yeah, this team is not made to break stall, like, there's no point. I'm talking around, let me pause it in case he comes back. We will see if he comes back and we will get one more after this game is awful, huh? This right here is why you never give up in Pokemon, because this guy had like no way to lose. I mean, he tried to throw Sableye away, but he pretty much didn't have a way to lose this game, even after throwing Sableye away. But yeah, he just set it to timeout, so we take that, we take those. Let's get another one, and yeah, we'll have to change this team, or if you guys want to use it, you have to make changes, because it's too weak to stall. Oh, I've seen this opponent in a video from a guy I'm sub to. So, I remember that he's Dragon Dance, Z-Move Gyarados, Zard Y, Gengar was Scarf, I think. I don't remember 100%. And Ferrothorn was like Fist Death. Oh, Scarf Nape seems like a solid lead overall. Like, just see what he leads. Act accordingly. I can just click U-turn because... Okay, he's Scarf Gengar, yeah. Didn't I just say he's Scarf? I thought for some reason he was Specs. I mixed that up because the other guy I played earlier. That was an awful play by me letting Ape take that hit. Should have gone other Momola, yeah. So he's locked into Shadow Ball. Yeah, let's just go Alo and make a double or something. Double into Napier. Trying to catch his Zard. Why would you go for... I guess that works. Like... I would have gone Zard if I was him. So we U-turning here. Shouldn't sag this. Exactly. I think this is Ice Beam Cheetah. So I want to just go my Bulu and click Superpower. Because... in case he goes for Ferrothorn here, I don't want to click Woodhammer. Otherwise, I would click Woodhammer. He could also go Zard. Yeah, he could go Zard, but that's fine. That does 50. Good God, Bandit Blue the gold. That does 50. Yeah, like I said, he's Zard, right? So we go Lari. Lari's my only play anyway. Nah, if he's Zardex, I could go Lando. He doesn't evolve. So he should go Ferrothorn or Tita here, so I can double. Can double into Tapu Bulu here if he stays in for some reason. I just look like a fool. There he goes, Tita, and I can go for Stone Edge, predicting his Zard. I don't have to make that play. Yeah, I shouldn't have made that play, but it works out because it hits the Gengar and the Gengar dies to a crit. Whew. I don't know if that crit mattered because Gengar's bad defenses and I'm banned, but he gets his Ferrothorn in for free now. Oh, let me see. Let me see if that mattered. I'm getting lucky today, good god. Yeah, that didn't matter. That's 103 minimum. Bandit Bulu doesn't play any games. Yeah, I don't know why he went into this when I have a Landorus right here. Get some chip off. We can just go for rocks. He's gonna go Ferrothorn or Zard. Or Gera, okay. So we know this is Z-move Gera. This is a threat. This is a threat. A big threat. He's Intimidate, which is nice, so he's not Z-move. Wait, why did that stay? I don't think staying in is the play, because... nah, he's Dragon Dancing here. We're staying in, yeah. Get that chip damage. Okay, nice crit. Wow, we're getting all the luck today. Can go Ape and bluff. Actually, I can go Stone Edge with Ape. I don't even have to bluff. If I go Nape... I don't know if Stone Edge kills, but I think that's my best play. The Sandstorm ends, and we just have to hit this edge if he stays in. He can go Ferrothorn if he wants to scout for... okay, never mind. I didn't thought he would lift that X. I didn't think he would lift that. He still has a Z-move. Yeah, I'm just gonna Shadow Sneak. We lose our Scarf, A, but we didn't really need it that much. It wasn't nice for ZY. But we have a Lari, so we should be fine. He goes Ferrothorn, good play. Good play, good play. I guess I should have SD there, but there's no way. Like, he switches out, he dies to Hazard, so I'm fine with that. He has to spin to keep this alive. So I assume he's just gonna go for Hazards. I'm just gonna SD up a few times. So he decides to throw up a Gyro Ball. Would be too nice if Dublade can win a game for me. It only... hey, what? It did some work. Oh, the guy just forfeited. Wow. So let's end it here. Let's just pretend Dublade won that game. I mean, pretty much won the game. He could have leeched me, but I just kept this D'ing up. And then Zard dies to Shadow Sneak. Tita, yeah, he should have tried to prevent him with Tita. But I know his Tita has Ice Beam, so maybe he doesn't have Crunchy. I think his Tita has Pursuit. I saw him use Pursuit. Like, I saw this guy in another YouTube video, like I mentioned. And yeah, even if he revenged Metal Blight, like, I think his team would have been severely weakened. Yeah, Steeta couldn't kill me because it only does like 30 or something if I stay in. Does like nothing. Still makes HP a Violite. The most annoying thing on this team is the Ferrothorn, but yeah, Dualblade sets up on it, and like after I lost Dualblade, Ferrothorn was really annoying, but I still had my Bandit Tabulu with superpower. Thank you guys for watching, hope you all enjoyed. I didn't play that well on this one. But yeah, I'm a bit rusty, like lately I've been watching people ladder, or just like my friends ladder. I haven't played that much myself, just that one session I did with T. So yeah, I gotta shake off the rust, gotta try to build better teams. This one is okay, but considering I build it in 3 minutes, it's not that bad, I think. Yeah, leave some suggestions. Oh yeah, if you're really good at team building, or just in general, it's really always nice to bounce off ideas with people. Hit me up on Skype, on Discord, but I'm more active on Skype, because, yeah, for some reason, some of our people in our Skype group, they don't have Discord, and our Skype chat is more active, so I just stay there most of the time. Hit me up if you want to join that. We can build together, that's always fun. I've mentioned that a few times in another video, and it's always in my description. Yeah, so what can you guys expect this week? I will ask my friends for a guest live. I might record later with my dude Padlob. So we did a live yesterday, but he's way too wild. Like, I had to end it. He was going all insane. I just didn't feel I wanted to upload that video because, like, Mans is like always rapping and stuff. Like, you guys can leave a comment down below if you like I'm So Sorry Lol, and I will get him again for a guest live, but I feel like sometimes he's too wild. But yeah, I'm just joking, my dude, you're funny. But yeah, Mans, like, he kept shit talking me also yesterday in the video. That's also another reason why I don't want to upload it. Yeah, you guys can expect OST this week. We have the Poik vs NJP, not Poik vs NJP, that was last series. We have Poik vs I Love League. We have ABR, we have Bengay with J Stays, I forgot how you pronounce him, and I forgot what the last match is. The last match is Malekith versus Loud Outrage, so pretty hyped. Stay tuned for that. OUPL gonna be starting soon, stay tuned for that. Content is gonna be coming. World Cup is like in 2 or 3 months, that content is gonna be coming. So yeah, it's gonna be a fun time. Peace out, friends.